being here tonight. I am Ashley Bontje, the director, and this is Nicola Davies, our pianist. And joining us is our guest musician, Nathan Sands, on drums. Before we begin, I'd like to thank St. Paul's Anglican Church for the use of this beautiful space, and to our sponsor, Davey Dosa, for their continued support. Joyful Voice is a non-audition community choir that began in the early 2000s, and we are so thrilled to have you here with us tonight as we sing songs of love and hope, including a few sing-alongs. Our first song, Super Trooper by ABBA, is one of several songs suggested by choir members, and our soloist is Kelly Nichol, who is a new member with us this season. Super Trooper appeared on ABBA's 1980 album of the same name and talks about the exhaustion of being so famous. The Super Trooper itself refers to a type of spotlight used at large concert and stadium events, and this arrangement features our alto section. Throughout the concert, you'll hear solos, instrumentals, and introductions by many members of the choir, and more than half the songs tonight were suggested by members. So I hope you feel inspired and uplifted by our songs. Thanks again, and here's Super Trooper.
fields of gold. Many of you may remember it as a song written by, I always forget his name, Sting. Sting, I don't know why I forget his name. I guess I'm supposed to introduce myself too. And this is the last night, it's not as if I can work on it and get better. So my name is Michael Moran and I'm a bass. I've been in the choir for a long time, I don't remember how long, but David was the conductor. So for some of you that might mean something. Fields of Song, Fields of Gold.
Ashley, would you like to start?
Fields of Gold was written by Sting in 1993. He had purchased a manor house surrounded with barley. This song didn't do that well on the billboards, but it did reach number 2 in Canada and number 6 in Iceland. This is what Sting himself thought about his song. In England, our house is surrounded by barley fields, and in the summer, it's fascinating to watch the wind moving over the shimmering surface, like waves on an ocean of gold. There's something inherently sexy about the sight, something primal, as if the wind were making love to the barley. Lovers have made promises here, I'm sure, their bonds strengthened by the comforting cycle of the seasons. A critic in a outfit called Pop Rescue, which means nothing to me, stated, "This song is so wonderfully mellow and flows so perfectly that it's near impossible to find fault with it." And the ultimate praise came from Paul McCartney, who, when he first heard it performed by Sting, said he wished he'd written it himself. That's song number one. The second song is The Rainbow Connection, which many of you will remember is part of the Muppets movie. It was written in 1979 by Paul Williams and Kenneth Asher. You might remember Paul Williams. I've never heard of Kenneth Asher, but it seems they're both prolific writers and singers. And it was performed by Jim Henson as Kermit the Frog at the beginning of the movie. And he told the writers that the opening scene should feature Kermit the Frog by himself, singing and playing the banjo. Williams was particularly attached to some of the lyrics. These were the ones he liked the most. "Who said that every wish would be heard and answered when wished on the morning star?" Somebody thought of that, and someone believed it. Look what it's done so far. He said, these lyrics point out that there is power in your thoughts. Williams and Asher were nominated for Academy Awards for the film. They didn't win, but they were nominated. And in 2020, the American Library of Congress, deemed this song culturally, historically, and aesthetically significant. So that's what you're about to hear. And hope you enjoy it. Then.
is Rainbow Connection, and you're invited to join us.
Expressly for the film An Officer and a Gentleman, starring Richard Gere. the scene of him,
spoiler alert,
sweeping Deborah Winger out of the factory is fundamental rom-com stuff and likely a good part of why this song won an Oscar for its writers. One of those writers was Buffy St. Marie. Many are likely aware that Miss St. Marie is a multi-award winning indigenous artist born in Saskatchewan, but taken from her parents in the 60s scoop and adopted by an American family. She has had a remarkable career and continues to tour at the age of 82. Don't miss her if you have the chance. This song is very well suited to Vancouver because although we can't offer you Richard Gere strolling in mid-song to sweep you out of your life, we do have eagles and mountains. And looking on the bright side is what we are all about with our song selection today. And the third song is Lean On Me, and we jump back to 1972 for this one. It was written by another notable black performer, Mr. Bill Withers. Mr. Withers has said that he wrote Lean On Me after moving to Los Angeles and being inspired by a yearning for the strong ties and community connections from his upbringing in a tiny coal mining town in rural Virginia, a place he has also written that he wanted to get away from, as he was the youngest of six from a very poor family with few economic prospects. Mr. Withers enlisted in the Navy and became an aircraft mechanic, but eventually found his way to the stage. Thankfully for all of us, as he also wrote Ain't No Sunshine, Lovely Day, and Just the Two of Us. I wonder what Johnny, Buffy, and Bill would think if they wandered by this 150-year-old church on a Monday night, 50 years after they wrote these songs, and heard our little community choir working these rhythms and harmonies with rock star focus. We hope you will feel the community spirit and sense of fun we feel as we perform these songs for you.
Clearly now the rain is gone. Thank you. My name is Ed Lee, and I've been with Joyful Voice since September of 2019. So far, we've heard a couple of songs. Did you enjoy them?
Yeah. All right.
So we've heard a song about loving in absence, I guess. And then we heard something about rainbow illusions. And then getting clarified. And a lofty goal to love. So in this next set, we're going to hear about how we do that now. So the first song will be a song by Sia. It's Courage. And some of you will know Courage to Change. It actually is from her movie that she directed. And the movie is about a very young woman in recovery named Sue, and her sister is on the autism spectrum, and she's going to be working with her sister. So Pink, we're going to sing the version done by Pink, which leaves out the first verse. So I want to read the first verse to you. World, I want to leave you better. I want my life to matter. I'm afraid I have no purpose here. I watch the news on TV, abandon myself daily. I'm afraid to let you see the real me. Following Courage, the choir will sing One Voice that was written by Ruth Moody, a founding member of the Wailing Jennies, a group out of Winnipeg. And Ruth wrote this at 2 a.m. in the morning on an open jam session. And some people have called it the most perfect of songs. And the sentiment in it is quite lovely. She said herself, not only is there a lot of division and unrest in the world because of COVID, people can't actually physically be together. So I think the message of One Voice is doubly important because it's about coming together and joining together, and it's about peace. And watch out for a very special soloist. By the way, both Courage and One Voice were arranged by our choir director, Ashley. And last but not least, we're going to be all singing together one of my favorite anthems, Bridge Over Troubled Water, written by Paul Simon. And it appeared on the album in the 1970s, the last album that Simon and Garfunkel were to make before they went on their separate ways. And when you do sing, sit up tall, get a lot of lung capacity, and when you breathe in, you get a lot of endorphins, and that makes us happier. And if you like that happy rush, come join us. We are a community choir of unauditioned voices, and you can sign up at the back. So hopefully you will enjoy the next three songs.
I'm walking uphill, no place hurts. I carry my heart through the dirt.
sing along. Bridge over troubled water.
When you're weary. Austrian Alps were alive with the sound of yodeling. In Liverpool, England, a rather different kind of music was being performed. The Fab Four, also known as the Beatles, admired American rock and roll, and they put their distinctive stamp on rock music for a decade. The song Let It Be is the title track from the band's 12th and final studio album, released in May 1970. It was written and sung by Paul McCartney. He said the song was inspired by a dream he had, in which his mother, who had died when he was 14 years old, told him, "It's gonna be okay, just let it be." His mother's name was Mary. You'll hear that name. The arrangement we will sing is by our talented director, Ashley. And if you listen closely, starting in the second chorus, you will hear the alto section, followed by the baritones, saying the words from another famous Beatles song. Let It Be features solos from Brian, Jenny, Brandy, Amy, and first, we will take you to the mountains, where it might be a little cooler, maybe.
Thank you. Thank you. We love